टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रियल विजिट एंड द इंडस्ट्रियल टूर इन द इंस्टीट्यूट्स. व्हाट इज द इंडस्ट्रियल टूर, व्हाट आर द स्टेप्स ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रियल टूर एंड व्हाई इट इज इम्पोर्टेंस फॉर द इंडस्ट्रियल विजिट. Industrial tour is a specially designed itinerary integrating the industry for a visit along with the other tourism destination. The whole idea is to encourage the learning through the observation of the industrial practices, how the industrial practices are happening. To know the observation of the industrial practices, making the students aware of themselves through long distance travel, which is always an eye-opening experience of discovering oneself. And these visits are aligned with the previous subjective additioning of the students in respective professional fields that may vary from architecture and space science. The objective of the industrial tour, what is the objective of the industrial tour? What is the objective of the industrial visit? The main objective of the industrial tour is to lessen the gap between the classroom teaching and the practical working environment and to bring in some positive intangible changes to the personality of the student, which results from the long distance group travel and the industrial visit. This is the main objective of the industrial tour or the visit, to lessen the gap between the classroom teaching and the practical working environment. And it is must to be remain mandatory for the any of the BTEC environment, BTEC student, MTEC student, and the PhD students. It is must be mandatory to visit the industrial tour or the industrial visit. The philosophy and the seven steps of the organizing the industrial visit. The philosophy underlying the industrial tour is the student-centered learning with the emphasis on the outcome-based education. When a student visits the industry, his decision for what he wants to be strengthens, a little push and the right kind of the guidance may increase the learning capacity of this particular student to a great extent. This can in fact increase the signaling effect of any particular institution in a long run. There are few steps that we encourage the institution to take while designing the industrial tour. And right kind of the guidance may increase the learning capacity of this particular student to a great extent. Step one, conditioning the student. Encourage the student to come up with a possible layout of the premises that they are going to visit after the briefing of the site. The possible layout may vary from subject to subject and should be strictly based on the previous conditioning of the students in their respective subjects. Student must be aware of the respective subjects in the practical manner in the industry. For example, if you are visiting a dairy plant, management student may come up with a possible management plan beginning from the procurement procedure to the distribution channel, whereas the engineering students are concerned, they may come up with the flow diagram of the processing unit. This activity will condition the student with the possibility of what they are going to observe, and this pre-visit step is necessary to achieve the outcome-based learning. Dedicate at least two to three class hours for conditioning the student. Step two, framing the questions in the mind of the students that what are happening in the industry. Student learn what are the questions may be arise and what are the things there are two types of the question that may appear in students' mind which may they want to ask. First one will be premeditated based on the previous subjective or the personal conditioning, and the second one on the observation of the sight. Observation of the sight is necessary. Observe the sight and conclude what's happening in the industry, what the process is going on in the industry. So understanding these questions are very much important. Institutions are recommended to have an insight about these possible questions so that a redirection can be made before embarrassment can occur. This can be done by arranging a question and answer section before the departure. Step 3, designing of what to observe questionnaire. The objective of designing a questionnaire is to systemize and sequentialize the observational learning of the student. This can be done by utilizing the secondary data or with a brief consultation with the industry person about the layout. What is the layout of the plant? Student can learn the layout of the plant, organization and structure of the plant, business philosophy of the plant, procedure and the process which are happening in the plant. For example, if you are beginning for a visit in an auto part manufacturing unit, the mechanical institute, and you come to know that the factory has an injection molding plant, then you can have essential question pertaining to the injection molding in your questionnaire. Once the student are done with the possible layout and the possible question and the institution with that of the observed questionnaire, the institutional guide who is assigned with the job or conducting the tour will realize the area of discrepancy that exists and can take corrective measures. Step 4, briefing about do's and don'ts before starting the journey. Students should be briefed about the expected behavior, deviation, and its consequences. This will help them to be focused on their objective and will help in maintaining long-term relationship with the industry. With the right kind of attitude, you can always make a lot of the friends. Apart from this, students should be briefed about what to do, carry out, accumulate, and retain the information to fill in the what to observe questionnaire. Step 5, the industrial visit, the observational study of the practical working environment will connect the student to their theoretical conditioning and will bridge the gap between the theory and the practices. Here, it is very necessary for them to record every relevant aspect that is in relation to their respective subject so that later on they can fill the questionnaire and retain what they have observed and learned as an industrial visitor. During the visit, student should interact with the industry person in a manner that could open up further opportunity for them or their successors. Step 6, after the industrial visit, student will be in a position to see the things in a better perspective. Most of them gets an idea of what they will be doing after the completion of the course. At this point, they should be asked to prepare a report in their visit. They must prepare a report in the industrial visit. Every student prepare a report in the case of the industrial visit. Better to prepare and see all about the layout process and that all the things. Report must be prepared by the every student. I always recommend this industrial report to go through the two different steps and then compiled in one. Step 1 should include the report based on what to observe questionnaire. Step 2 should be based on the subjective experience of the student about the industrial tour and the industrial visit. Step 7, compilation, submission, and the evaluation of the industrial tour report should be followed by the publication of the industrial event. Blogs, social media, college journal, college website are the best possible sites for the showcasing the industrial business. This in turn returns help the institution by publicizing to wide audience and hence may increase the signaling effect of the institution benefiting the students. These are the 7 steps of the industrial visit and industrial tour, that the how the industrial tour and the industrial visits can be done. These are the step 5, step 6. Step 4 and the other steps are given here. What is the industrial tour and what is the necessity of the industrial tour among the students? What is the necessity of the industrial tour among the students? Objective of the industrial tour. What is the objective of the industrial tour? The main objective of the industrial tour is to lessen the gap between the classroom teaching and the practical working environment. There is a gap between the classroom teaching and the practical working environment. Hence, this gap is fulfilled by the industrial tour and the industrial visit, that the what is happening in the industry in some positive intangible changes to the personality of the students which results from long distance group travel and the industrial visit. The philosophy and the 7 steps of the organizing industrial visit. The philosophy underlying the industrial tour is student-centered learning with emphasis on the outcome-based education. This is given here. Here is the step 1, step 2, step 3, and up to the 7 steps are there of the industrial visit and the industrial tour.